this box, you want me to open this box? Dude, I could run in these boots.
As you know, our boots are known for durability, rugged work environments, they're heavy, they're beefy, they're the best work boots on the market. However, with that said, numerous law enforcement agencies have come to us saying, hey, we love your boots, we love the construction, we love that you're USA made, but your boots are not great for catching the bad guys. They're pretty heavy, they're not very agile. And for many years, we just said, well, we're beefy and we're burly. Sorry, we don't have a solution for you. Your requests, though, have not fallen on deaf ears. And today, we're pumped to reveal something special. And no, it's not this incredible Chiefs coat from Heat Straps in New Jersey. It's actually what's underneath. Let's talk about the features of this boot, then we'll discuss who this boot's for, and we'll talk about some of the innovative technology around it. The first feature of this boot is the padded collar made out of a high durability cloth material. We're also gonna allow you to do it in leather, and we're also gonna allow you to do it in just the standard Knix top, which is pretty common on most of our boots. The second feature is the boot height. This is gonna be an 8-inch boot here. We're also gonna give you the option to cut her down to 6 inches. Feature number 3 is the leather. We're excited to be introducing some more leathers to our collection. This boot here in my hand is made out of our classic Knix 7-to-8-ounce black leather. We're also gonna offer this boot in a water-resistant leather, which is silicone-infused. Notice it does have a little bit of a gray tint to it. That's because of the silicone infusion, but this stuff is designed to repel water a little bit better than the standard Knix black. Thirdly, we're excited to be offering the Knix 1964 black. Our 1964 medium brown has been a hit. We went to the tannery and we said, let's do it in black. This is a little bit more easy break-in. It's the same 7-to-8-ounce material. It just is infused with wax and oils that expedite the break-in period a bit. Stay tuned on our next video where we're gonna talk about all of our new work leather options. I'm gonna let you in on a little secret as well. I'm pretty sure we're gonna be making a coyote tan version of this boot real soon. Next is a cool but non-functional enhancement here, but we've added a little bit of a square shape to our heel counters to kind of differentiate the tactical boot from some of our other logger styles. Next are hardware options. The bestseller is gonna default with gunmetal black eyelets. We're also gonna give you an option to do brass. We're also gonna give you an option to do hooks and eyes. One benefit of all eyelets is you can add a Knix zipper into this boot. Whoa, that's pretty cool, wow. Feature number 4, or maybe it's number 5, I'm losing track, is the laces. These boots are gonna default with iron laces. This is a Kevlar-like material that's unbreakable and guaranteed for life. Feature number 17 is the Vibram Sierra sole. The cool thing about this sole is it's built on a polyurethane wedge base for added cushion and durability. But the bottom skin, so to speak, or outsole, is 100% solid rubber. Very similar compound to what you'll find on our V100 lug soles. Now let's get into some of the mind-blowing features of this boot. Before we go into the mind-blowing features of this boot, let's talk about, again, who this boot is designed for. This boot really fulfills 4 requirements. Number 1, lightweight with some cushion. Number 2, some bulk reduction. Number 3, water resistance. And the 4th requirement is a dress code requirement. We wanted a boot that could meet most law enforcement agency requirements as well as many of the military specs. All right, mind-blowing feature number 1. This boot is 360-degree stitched. Just like our vamp on most of our other boots, which is flared out and stitched down. On this boot, we flared out the heel counter as well and stitched all the way through 360 degrees. This prevents any water or moisture from entering into the insole of the boot. Feature number 2, again, to enhance the water resistance and longevity of this boot, we've actually built the boot around a rubber insole. Rubber is a fantastic material for flexibility and longevity, This material's never gonna wear out, and it doesn't really absorb moisture like a leather insole might. The beauty of this construction method is now you can insert a leather insole on top of the rubber insole. And as your leather insole wears out, you throw it away and you put a new one in. Mind-blowing feature number three is a rubber midsole. Again, leather is an amazing material if you're not in wet weather conditions. When you're in wet weather conditions, leather can be problematic sometimes. In previous videos, we've talked about how when leather meets rubber, there's a potential for some delamination. It's normal, the boot's not ruined, but you start to see separation between the dislike materials or the dissimilar materials. In our tactical boot, we are utilizing a rubber midsole, which is adhered to that rubber insole, which gives you an incredible bond. And it pretty much prevents any form of delamination between dissimilar materials. Again, this is perfect for wet weather applications. And again, rubber all around has a bit more flex and less bulk than thick leather. Mind-blowing feature number four is the outsole. We've talked about this previously, but let's talk about it some more. We have the benefit of a polyurethane, more flexible cushion material as your base, and it's skinned with a full rubber outsole. So you're getting the full rubber outsole durability combined with some of the polyurethane cushion. Again, making this boot lighter weight and more agile. At this point, your mind is probably blown, but you might be thinking, wait a second, you guys are stealing the leather and putting the rubber in? Is Nix going to China? Is Nix all synthetic now? Are these mostly made offshore and then just finished in Spokane?
Not by the hair of my chinny chin chin.
Actually, no. This boot isn't cheaper. The materials are actually a bit more expensive. It actually takes a bit more time for a bootmakers to build them. Again, the intent of this boot is for a specific function, for those that need a lighter weight boot, those that need a bit more flex, those that need optimal water resistance. That's who this boot is for. Just like how our hotshots and our builder pros and our linemen and our Roberts and our Packers have specific functions and applications, this boot is no different. This is again designed for those that need the agility and need the water resistance. This boot is not Goodyear welted. It's stitched down just like all of our boots, and it's even an enhanced stitch down because of that 360 degree stitch. Just like all of our other boots, it's fully rebuildable, fully resoleable. There are zero compromises in this boot. At this point, you might be thinking, this is too good to be true. A Nix boots that I can run in, a Nix boots I can chase the bad guys in. The good news is we've got more similar boots on the horizon. So go ahead and like and subscribe because we're gonna be revealing more boots for different applications using a very similar build construction. Thanks for watching.
It almost kind of looks like a, you know, pew pew. I think I'm gonna actually run Bloomsday in these. I think I could run 8 miles in these boots. I'm not even kidding. Maybe we should do like a sponsor grant to run Bloomsday in a pair of the Nix tactical boot. Check out this coat. Like, there's nothing in it. This is just 100% incredible bulk. There's nothing better than well-built coats and well-built boots.